What's up, y'all? This is your girl, Miss Maggie T with Atlanta Falcons Nation. Want to go ahead and get you guys to the quick updates because there's a little bit to talk about, and I want to get it to you guys in less than 10 minutes. Let's see what I can do. Falcons wide receiver Bryan Edwards, who fell on his shoulder in Saturday's practice, and he left early. Well, it looks like he's projected he's just going to be day-to-day, according to Arthur Smith. So there's no too much of a concern for him. So he'll be returning sooner or later. We'll keep an eye out on that. Good news there. As far as Deion Jones, there is no timeline on his return at the moment. But interesting report from Jeff Schultz said the Falcons have failed in attempts to this point to trade Deion Jones, but have decided not to cut him. According to some sources, believing he won't be a distraction to team and salary cap savings are minimum. The team continues to monitor Jones' attitude and rehab from shoulder surgery. He won't be a distraction. Monitoring his attitude. Does that sound like Deion Jones to you? If anything, I've seen him out there getting his, at least his workout on, his rehab on that shoulder just a little bit. I feel like if Deion Jones was an attitude or a problem to this league, oh, he would have been up out of here early. But of course, I'm not downing the trade talks, because this new regime, they're definitely always open, answering the calls to any situation. You know, so maybe we can bring in something different. Nonetheless, I'm not shooting that down, but the attitude, puzzling. But let's get right into padded practice, you guys. The pads were on yesterday, and it started off with those punters. Falcons had punters Bradlin Pinion and Seth Vernon. They did get some directional punting work in. Now Arthur Smith is saying our expectations for Pinion are high. We anticipate him being that guy. So, okay, starting to, you know, circle around certain players at this point. But that competition is still circulating there. I'd love to get to that preseason so we can start cutting down this roster even more. But nonetheless, you know, high praise from Arthur Smith. Now, 707 passing drills in the red zone. Quarterback Marcus Mariota was 3 of 5, and Desmond Ridder was 2 of 3 with touchdown passes to Damir Bird and tight end Felipe Franks. Felipe Franks out there getting his workout on. I'm loving to see that they found a place for him, even though he, you know, still subject to be that emergency, quote-unquote, third quarterback if need be. We're hoping not. But any day is any day, you guys. But Felipe Franks is out there really taking this position role seriously, getting his steps in from, you know, getting opinions in. I'm loving it. Now, the offensive line. Of course, now with the pads on, that competition is starting going to get intense. Well, the Falcons opened their padded practice with Drew Dahlman at center and Elijah Wilkinson at left guard. And that's in place of Matt Hennessy and Jalen Mayfield. Now, interestingly enough, it's starting to look like Wilkinson is gearing towards getting that starting left guard. But that's the beast of the nature of the game and competition. It's anybody's, you know, position at the end of the day. So who wants it the most? And Arthur Smith did have some words about him. There are things that he is doing that we are pleased with and doing it the way we feel it needs to be done. Falcons coach Arthur Smith said when asked about Wilkinson over Mayfield. So I think it is a good thing for Jalen to see if he can step up. Like I said, competition brings out the best in everybody, and we'll see where it goes. I'm not down on Jalen, but it's more that we are more pleased with what Elijah is doing right now. Come on now. And Arthur Smith means that. You know, hey, if you're not doing the job, sit on down. I'm going to work with what works best for business. So, Jalen, hey, pay attention, dude. But hey, like I said, it's still early. It's a long week of practice. It could change at any day, you guys. Now, also, Tyler Allgeier, you know, I was asked about, and this was his off-season workouts and things, and he said, I was getting into the best shape of my life. He said that studying the playbook, it was just doing that day in and day out, because the faster you learn the playbook, the faster you'll be on the field. You know, well, you know that Arthur Smith just wants that to be clear to his locker room. Algier said that he made that known day one of practice. He said, Coach Smith want us to be the most physical, fast, mentally tough team as well. And we are seeing it. We're hearing it. Like, these guys are out there with their books, taking this serious, because it's like, yeah, somebody else, a rookie, can come in and take my position. And I don't want that. I'm here to stay. So it'll be interesting enough leading into preseason who wants it bad enough. And Arthur Smith even said, you want to see how they perform day in day. Excuse me. Smith said of what he expects with the pads going on. This week is a good proving ground. It's a long week for these guys. I think we'll have a good idea then about where we're at. It's a grind physically and also mentally. There's a lot of movement going on out here, but they're really taxed mentally during the stretch. Think he is really showing that going on into Algier. Just again, especially with how practice has been going, and especially in meetings as well. He's really instilling that in them, definitely. Now, let's talk about Grady Jarrett. Man, pads came on and he got out there and got to business. The first two plays of that 11-on-11 period in practice, he made quick work of the offensive line upon the snap. Now, tackling wasn't allowed for the first play of practice, but most likely it would definitely have been a significant tackle for a loss. And the second, a sack. Of course, Jarrett put the pads on and he just went to work. Definitely. So you love to see that he is just pumped. You know, he wants to be that leader for the team. You heard it in that previous press conference of his. He's a go-getter. He's a teacher as well. And we want that on our squad. Get these rookies in shape and himself, because, hey, somebody else can come in and take it too. You never know. But, hey, I love it. I absolutely love it to see that. We need that, definitely, because we need aggressive men on that defense. Now, that's all I got as far as news and updates. And I did it in less than 10 minutes again. I'm awesome. I'm awesome. Now, that's not all the highlight, but this is basically what I could capture as far as the news and updates. You guys, I appreciate you tuning in. I think we have, I don't know if it's heavy hitters tonight or the cooler talk, which one ever, y'all make sure y'all tune into that at 8 o'clock Eastern Standard Time. And then the guys will actually be on an hour early or 2 hours early. I'll give you guys an update on the time, but you know, hey, preseason is in and the Hall of Fame game is coming. So we got to accommodate you guys so you can get your news and updates anyway from us, but not interfere with your football watching, because football is back, baby. All right, you guys, until the next time, this is Maggie T with Atlanta Falcons Nation. And we are the nation, you guys. Oh, and by the way, we do have Kelly Price coming in on August 4th as well. You guys don't want to miss that. It's been confirmed 2:30 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Y'all tune into that. She's going to also break it down with some better highlights from training camp, because she's there physically, you guys, in the works getting these interviews. So this is going to be highly exciting. She's from Fox 5 Sports. So you guys check it out. Please put that alert on so you won't miss that episode. We appreciate you once again. And I'm out, people. Peace.